was the Bach Italian Concerto. So even before I was in kindergarten, I was plunking away at the keys. So my folks sent me for piano lessons in my hometown of Pueblo, Colorado, a small town on the prairie surrounded by cactus and cowboys. Even before I, my first teacher had bright orange hair and she smoked cigarettes during my lessons. And she taught me songs with descriptive names like Country Gardens. Good to smell the flowers, right? Or the Skater's Waltz. But my favorite, the Cossack Dance. She taught me how to count one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. But what she never taught me was technique. And by technique, I mean scales and arpeggios. Designed to teach our fingers patterns and to make them stronger. But because I never had any technique, I struggled with my little tiny fingers trying to push down the heavy, gigantic piano keys. But it was okay because music was my shining star. I was special because I was a musician. I played the piano. Not everyone played the piano, but I did. And yet I always thought I wasn't good enough and no one wanted to listen to me. You see, my family was divided into two groups. My mom, my sister Jessie, and me in one group, and my dad in another, by himself. Daddy played the trombone, and he loved playing jazz and big band music. So even though he had a 9-to-5 job at a TV station, on evenings and weekends, he was off playing jazz. So while I diligently practiced my classical music, my dad was off doing his own thing. It was only like 10 years ago that I realized that musical families play together, like all the time, the whole family. I mean, the Partridge family did, the Von Trapp family, but not us. Jazz was Daddy's world. It was like this secret club I wasn't allowed to join. Daddy was a cool jazz musician, and he didn't really think very much of classical musicians. He called them squares. So I guess that made me a square classical musician. But I do have sweet Daddy memories, like the time he taught me how to clap a 2-against-3 rhythm at the dinner table. So in fact, I'm gonna teach you all how to do that. All right, so. Don't be shy. So first we clap 2 with one hand, so try that, 1, 2. And then we clap 3 with the other hand, all right? Here we go, 1, 2. Very good, very good, very good. So now when you go home tonight or to your hometown, you too will be able to play the Debussy arabesque because it has a 2-against-3 rhythm. And I already said that about musical families, and didn't I? Anyway, so I was determined to leave Pueblo, and I got into college as a piano major at the University of Denver, where I actually won the annual concerto competition. About myself. My world was getting bigger and so were my insecurities. I loved playing the piano, but when I played, I would have these yapping demons in my head telling me I wasn't good enough and no one wanted to listen to me. And oftentimes when I was on stage by myself performing, I would have major anxiety attacks. But for some reason, my teacher continued to encourage me and suggested that I should audition for graduate school at his alma mater, the Manhattan School of Music in New York City, and that I should study with his teacher, Dora Zaslavsky. So I skipped my college graduation and flew to New York for the audition. When I got to New York, I quickly realized that New York was very different than Pueblo. For one thing, everybody in New York walks. In Pueblo, if people see you walking down the street, they figure your car is broken and they offer to pick you up. Everybody in Pueblo wore bright colored clothing, but people in New York were dressed in black, like there was a citywide funeral going on. This was a whole different world, and I liked it. Now, the next day was my audition, and I got really nervous. I mean, what if I messed up? What if they didn't like me? And all the demons started yapping away in my head. Hi, I'm Cynthia Shaw, I'm from Pueblo, Colorado, and I'll be playing Beethoven. How's it going? So I convinced my parents, and they let me go. So on a warm September day, I flew to New York. Now, the first thing I had to do was find a place to live. So I rented a small studio apartment on the Upper West Side where all of the classical musicians lived. Then I bought a beat-up old upright grand piano so that I could practice for my lessons with Dora Zaslavsky. Adora was a legend at Manhattan School, where she had been teaching since the 1920s. She was cultured and sophisticated, but also arrogant and condescending. I played my Bach partita for her. No, 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 Cynthia, you need to play with more passion, more drama. Scoot over and let me show you how an artist plays. Make love to the piano. Every Wednesday, Dora had a piano soiree at her huge Central Park West apartment. All of the other pianists were amazing, and they played like this. Carnegie Hall and hear famous pianists. There'd be burly Russian pianist Lazar Berman playing Liszt. Or petite Spanish pianist Alicia de la Rocha playing Mozart. Dreamy Italian pianist Maurizio Pollini playing Schubert. But the highlight of it all was hearing Vladimir Horowitz play his rousing transcription of John Philip Sousa's Stars and Stripes Forever. Was love. City. But I began asking myself, why do I need to go to graduate school? And all I knew was that I did not want to go back to Pueblo. And playing the piano was my ticket out. So I had my second Manhattan School audition. I didn't get in. And because I had embarrassed Dora in front of all the other piano teachers, she dismissed me. But thankfully, I found another teacher who taught me how to really audition for graduate school and for my third audition. Hi, I'm Cynthia Shaw, and I'll be playing Brahms. Master's degree in piano performance from the Manhattan School of Music. To Gail and Sage Artists for sponsoring me. So have a nice night. Thank you.